you know, one of those things, you get a cold, you're not going to, you know, you're going to take care of it, take a couple aspirin, take some over-the-counter medicine. It just got worse. You know, you got a little fever, nothing big. Sunday night, my husband wanted to call the ambulance. And I was like, no, I'm fine. I kept on saying, I'm fine. The next morning, he called the doctor, and we went in. And when he did the pulse ox, you know, that little thing they put on your finger, it measured 50. And he's like, you need to go to the ER. They put me in a paralytic coma. They needed to do that to keep me still. So I was on the ventilator. You know, I'm still finding out things. You know, I went into renal failure, so I had to do dialysis. So I was basically on life support. While I was in the coma, everybody keeps asking me, do you hear people? And they said, you kinda, but it's you put your own spin on it, like their words. I remember hearing the alarms of the machines, and I always thought it was a car horn. So it would irritate me, be like, why do you keep on beeping the horn? I remember my husband, like, if he was leaving, he would come and say goodbye, or I'll be back. And I'd be like, why is he leaving? He's always leaving. But it was like a dream state, you know? And I wasn't in a hospital. It was just like you were somewhere else. My kid's been without me. My daughter's in eighth grade, so it's kind of hard. She has so many things going on. Her entrance exams, her graduation pictures, you know, so I had to have my sisters do a lot. It was just hard not being there. My son's baseball games, I missed his first basket. Tomorrow, I'm going to go home.
Alrighty, no more hospital, yay! Yay. It's been a long journey.
How many days?
74 days,
74
right?
Days.
Yeah, 74 days.
I had so much support, family, friends, and I think it just brings everything into perspective. And you kind of like, you don't worry about the little things anymore. You appreciate life a lot more. That's what you do.